Today, I will talk about light-inducible control of protein-protein interaction based on Arabidopsis thaliana. Light-inducible control of protein-protein interactions provides powerful optical tools for manipulating biological processes expecting to be useful for controlling a broad range of cell phenomena with high temporal and spatial resolution. In this presentation, I will introduce two representative light-mediated protein-protein interaction systems based on Arabidopsis thaliana that are completely suitable for mammalian cells. The main characters are cytochrome B cytochrome interaction factor that is called PIF and cryptochrome 2 and CIB1 interaction. First paper demonstrated the use of a new genetically encoded light control system based on an optimized reversible protein-protein interaction from the cytochrome signaling network of Arabidopsis thaliana. Cytochromes are photoreceptive signaling proteins responsible for mediating many light-sensitive processes in plants, including seed germination, seeding deethylation, and shade avoidance. The working principle is simple. Cytochromes detect red and near-infrared light through the photoisomerization of a covalently bound chromophore picocyanoblin PCB, and this photoisomerization event is coupled to an allosteric transition in the cytochrome between two conformational states called PR, red absorbing region, and PFR, far red light absorbing. There are various kinds of cytochromes and PIF interactions. However, among them, only cytochrome B and PIF6 interaction has rapid photoreversibility property in mammalian cells. Using light-inducible protein-protein interaction property, researchers optimized and constructed various systems. Preferentially, they observed photoreversible translocation of protein to the plasma membrane. They used the YFP tagged PIF domain in cytosol and cytochrome P tagged by mCherry on plasma membrane. Then they observed the binding ability according to red light illumination or infrared light illumination. Confocal microscopy imaging reveals that cytosolic PIF YFP translocates to plasma membrane under red light illumination and translocates from the membrane to cytosol under infrared light illumination. For reference, they also measured the kinetics of the cytochrome-induced cytoplasmic depletion of PIF-YFP under maximum illumination yielded translocation time constants of 1.5 seconds for membrane recruitment and 4 seconds for membrane release. These rates are very near the physical limits for whole cell diffusion. They developed also fully automated method of controlling the distribution of both light frequencies on the cell membrane by using a digital micromirror array to project patterned light onto the sample plane of the microscope at micrometer resolutions. By irradiating the sample with 650 nanometer and 750 nanometer light sources oriented to take advantage of both micromirror angle states, a complementary two-color red-infrared pattern can be projected onto the sample plane, allowing one to paint high-resolution inverse distributions of PFR and PR cytochrome onto the membrane of the cell. Torpor imaging reveals fine features at 5 micrometer, demonstrating an unprecedented degree of control over protein localization in living cells. This research suggests that the module has high potentiality of controlling a variety of cell phenomena with high spatial resolution. This novel cytochrome B PIF module would be highly applicable to many biological research, and the developers were highly motivated to engineer a membrane recruitment system. At last, they focused on spatial temporal control of the raw family GTPase REG1 CDC42, which of those are the dynamic spatial regulation of the actin cytoskeleton at the polarized edges of motile cells. Red laser illumination was used for localized recruitment of the thiam THPH domain in NIH3T3 cells, effecting within 5 to 10 minutes of localized lamellipodium blooms. By slowly extending the point of activating light away from the cell, it is even possible to draw out an extended process up to 30 mm from the main body of the cell that is stable after the light has been withdrawn. They further verified the signaling activity of ISDMPH-DHPH regions by TORP microscopy. Using these biosensors, they showed that GTPase activation occurs rapidly, within seconds, indicating that a subsequent signaling step is responsible for the typical delay of 5 to 10 minutes for lamellipodial and filopodial protrusions. These results indicate the future possibility of programmatically specifying cell geometries and intracellular connections with light. Second paper that I will introduce reported a genetically encoded light-inducible protein interaction model based on Arabidopsis thaliana, cryptochrome 2, and CIB1. Plant cryptochromes contain a conserved N-terminal photolytic homology region, PHR, that binds flavin and pterin chromophores and mediates light responsiveness. This photodimerization requires no exogenous ligands and dimerize on blue light exposure with subsequent time resolution and cellular spatial resolution. There are various kinds of cryptochromes like phytochromes implants. They found the cryptochrome 2 PHR and CIBN interaction has rapid photoreversibility under blue light in mammalian cells. As the similar manner with the phytochrome research, the researchers also observed the photoreversible translocation of protein from cytosol to the plasma membrane. They used the M-cherry tagged cryptochrome 2 PHR and membrane-associated CIBN EGFP. Then they observed the interaction under blue light illumination. Within 300 milliseconds after blue light illumination, cryptochrome 2 M-cherry began accumulating at the plasma membrane, where it localized with CIBN plasma membrane EGFP. Greater than 95% of cells exhibited robust translocation of cryptochrome 2 M-cherry to the plasma membrane, but the distribution of CIBN EGFP did not change after illumination. Translocation was more than 90% completed within 10 seconds. The complete time course of plasma membrane association and dissociation for the cryptochrome 2 PHR-CIBN interaction is also shown. After an initial pulse of light, cryptochrome 2 PHR M-cherry rapidly translocated to the plasma membrane and then slowly dissociated over 20 minutes. One powerful application of artificial dimerizers is to allow inducible control of a split protein in which two inactive fragments are brought together to reconstitute a functional protein activity. They used the cryptochrome CIB modules to reconstitute split versions of two proteins, a GAL4 transcription factor and Cre recombinase. Based on the transient nature of the cryptochrome CIB interaction, they speculated that light pulses would allow precise dose-dependent control of protein activity. They expressed in ST the split GAL4 partners, GAL4BD cryptochrome 2 and GAL4AD CIB1, together with a reporter protein under control of a galactose-inducible promoter. Each are incubated in the dark or subjected them to up to 20 blue light pulses over 4 hours. Immunoblood analysis revealed a strong dose dependence of protein expression in response to light. They also tested the ability of the cryptochrome CIB models to induce dimerization of split-cre recombinates, allowing light-dependent control of DNA recombination. As a reporter of Cre recombinate activity, they used the plasmid containing a transcriptional stop sequence flanked by LOXP sites preceding each FP. Cells containing cryptochrome 2 Cre and CIBN Cre C exposed to continuously pulsed blue light for 24 hours showed a 158-fold increase in the number of EGFP-expressing cells compared to samples incubated in the dark, indicating robust light-dependent activation. As this platform is entirely genetically encoded and can be activated using commonly available light sources, this model is expected to be useful for controlling a broad range of biological phenomena. In summary, I introduced two major light-inducible protein-protein interaction models based on Arabidopsis thaliana, which are phytochrome B PIF6 interaction and cryptochrome 2 CIB interaction. Researchers optimized and constructed various systems with these modules, including photoreversible translocating to the plasma membrane, patterned irradiating and activating cell, two hybrid transcription activators to tune the expression level of a targeted reporter gene, and even controlling raw family G protein signaling to migrate cells. Two modules have similar properties and advantages that provide high temporal and spatial resolution optical tools to control biological processes. However, there are some differences between two modules. The differences affect when we use light-sensitive interactive modules. Phytochrome B PIF6 modules can be used under specific light condition for interacting with the red light illumination and dissociating with the IR infrared light illumination. They are suitable to assemble proteins in orderly fashions. In contrast, cryptochrome 2 CIBN modules are always used under blue light illumination to interact. They are suitable for transient protein interaction, that is also called protein docking. The light-gated protein-protein interaction that has been optimized should be useful for the design of diverse light programmable reagents, potentially enabling a new generation of perturbative quantitative experiments in cell biology.